Hello YouTube, in this video I'm going to help you discern whether or not the transformation video that you just watched is legit or not. If you've actually witnessed someone go through the normal stages of evolution for a man or a woman and developed their body naturally. Because transformation videos are the tits, because on YouTube Fitness, the big part of the motivation that is involved in us watching other people is seeing them grow. Because as they grow, we can tell ourselves, okay, they did it, I can do it too. And that's pure, in my opinion, that's great. Because it gives you a good idea of what you are actually able to accomplish as well, even though you might not believe in yourself yet. The problem, of course, is that when something is pure, there's always people to try and denature that very thing. And that's what we've seen with a natural transformation. People who come in, claim that they've managed to accomplish X or Y in X amount of years, and they say they did it naturally when they didn't. So I want to share with you what I believe is the easiest way to tell that what they're saying is hogwash. And that is going to be the timeline. Bodybuilding is a game of patience. And especially once you're past puberty, it's going to be a slow evolution. Of course, when you first get started, you get those newbie gains, you look much better at a much faster rate, and a part of your brain sort of wishes that it's going to last forever, and of course it doesn't, eventually it slows down, and the more advanced you are, the more it slows down. If you know what you're doing and you apply yourself, it's never going to stop entirely, that is not possible, but the progression is not going to be as fast. And that can be a killer. A lot of people stop because they just don't get what they think they deserve, and therefore they quit and they tell themselves that they met a natural limit, which is nonsense. But you also have individuals that when you look at their transformation, they seem to have been able to accomplish a ton really, really fast. And some of them just say it's genetic, some of them say that it's because they work hard, etc. And that could be the case. Some people are just going to be lucky, they're going to make muscular gains faster. But there are limitations to everything in life, meaning that even someone who was blessed with an impossibly high and advantageous hormonal profile is still not going to be able to bypass the laws of biology, meaning that there is a hard cap to the amount of tests you can produce, and overall, people who are enhanced tend to have 3, 4, 5 times the amount of tests that even the most gifted individual is going to have. And that is important because it also means that there are transformations that are simply impossible. And to me, that is the number one thing I look at. If I look at a transformation, and from one frame to the other, there is a transformation that doesn't make sense, where they doubled in size, their delts became 3D, the shreds appeared out of nowhere. To me, it's a dead giveaway, because there can be no modification in the environment, training or nutrition that created such a change. The only thing that could have done that is a massive boost in hormonal profile. And if you want a good indication and a good example of that, look at my transformation video. It's slow, it's steady, the physique evolves, but it's not shocking. It's not like from one picture to the other, you look at a completely different individual. And that is something that you have to take to heart. Because too many people, especially young men, are going to see these things, they're going to idolize the person who posted that transformation, and they're going to think, wow, I'm going to train and it's going to be the same for me because he's natural and I'm natural. And so they train and the magic never happens. The insane size that those guys put on, the 20 pounds of muscle, it never materializes. And that can result in two things. One, you can think that it's your fault, that you're just a genetic dead hand and that lifting is useless because you didn't manage to replicate those insane results. Or two, you're going to become resentful. You're going to start pointing fingers at people and say, oh, okay, so that's enhanced, that's genetics, you're just lucky, and it's not my fault that I'm small. And those two things are both bad because they're going to take you away from the training. They're going to take your mindset into a dark place. To me, what you need to look at when you look at these transformations is you're looking at someone who used chemistry to enhance their body. That's what happened. And yes, they're dishonest about it. Of course they are, because they eventually transition into trying to sell you a product. That's a second dead giveaway. If they somehow link their transformation or insane blow up in size to a supplement, to a certain training program, or to anything that is going to require you to pay money, they're a fraud. Disregard that. The only thing that could get you those results is the testosterone or the steroids that they injected, and they're not going to be shipping that to you anytime soon. So be very careful. The transformations used to sell a product are always fraudulent, always. Because a real natural bodybuilder, someone who was able to build a strong and good-looking body, understands what it takes. Takes patience. And across the board, those kids that exploded and who completely modified their physique overnight don't get that. And they are going to poison you with the same mindset that took them there. Because you are going to also be tempted to do the same thing once you realize how they got there. Because you're going to think it's the only way. And I want you to know, it's not. The only way for naturals to get bigger and stronger is to train for a long time and be patient. You are not going to be massive in 2 years. Not even in 3 years. It can take time and it will take as long as it should take. For me, it took at least 7 years. And it's not that my training wasn't optimal, it's that I started super skinny and it takes a long time to build muscle. I went from 110 to 210. How long do you think that should take? If you tell me anything less than 10 years, I'm going to say that you're delusional. You've been parasited by those fake transformation videos. And that's pretty much that. It's the timeline. It's the connection that you're going to have with that video and you're going to be able to tell, okay, this is not normal. 6 months passed and you just transformed. You look completely different. You look like you've aged 10 years. What happened here? Well, you know exactly what happened here and they know also, but they're going to pretend that they don't. And the worst part and the cherry on top and the third that giveaway is that these people regress. These people get those insane physiques, but then down the line, they either go black on social media so that you can't see them off cycle, or they just look small out of nowhere. And they're always going to have an excuse. It's going to be injury, it's going to be because they lost motivation, something happened in their life. But I can tell you, as someone who has had to take breaks in the past, that natural muscle doesn't go away. Strength does go away, but it also comes back relatively fast. But the muscle, the aspect of the muscle, when you build it naturally, it stays on your frame as long as you don't go into a super high caloric deficit. And that also is, to me, one, great, because you know that if you're building it, you're going to keep it. And two, also an indication, right? If you one day you see me and I show up on cam and my biceps are gone, my traps are gone, there's something here, something happened. There was a modification because, just as I said, since a transformation in a positive side can only happen with a massive increase in hormonal profile, the opposite is also true. If you lose a ton of muscle, the only explanation is that. It's that your hormonal profile tanked. But understand that while these people have a trajectory that looks like this, okay, where they peak with the steroid use and then they regress and they enter that insane yo-yo that I have already spoken against in this playlist, naturals grow like this. It's very slow, it's very steady, but there's no dip. It's consistent. You can have trust in your body and you also don't really depend on hormonal profile. Your growth is going to depend on progression, which ultimately is the accumulation of tonnage. Yes, you're going to become more anabolic as you go because your body is going to adapt. Just like a crazy hormonal profile is going to boost the muscles, I personally believe that the growth of the muscle also forces the body to be more anabolic because it needs to offer an environment to the body to be able to feed and maintain those muscles. And that's the difference between enhanced transformations and natural transformations. And as a natural, I am preaching for the second. Stay natural. Take the time it takes. You're going to be glad that you didn't jump on PEDs in your later years. I can guarantee you that. And I'm going to leave you with that. Don't let those people feed you false expectations. Don't let those people make you think that you're not good enough. You are. They're liars and you're better than that. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.